Hello, my name is Edwin Mulimi, and I'm a special advisor at the Oslo Center. The Oslo Center is a Norwegian organization that was founded in 2006 with its headquarters in Oslo, Norway. And we predominantly work with political parties across the world. However, in the last 5 years, we have introduced a youth component within the our programming. And we have worked with youth assemblies in Mombasa, we have established in Kwale, and we have now initiated in Lamu. Youth assemblies is a concept that enables youth to leverage on the provisions of the Kenyan Constitution that provides for their participation in political, social, and economic and other spheres of life. And this is one tool to realize this constitutional provision. Historically, youth have been marginalized from decision-making processes. They have been excluded from meaningful participation where they have been included. It has been largely been tokenistic. So this structure is a structure that provides leadership skills, provides an opportunity and an avenue where young people can meaningfully participate and contribute to the social change they desire to see. They can meaningfully contribute and participate in the decision-making processes and governance processes at subnational and national level. This is also informed by the fact that youth form majority of the population in the country and on the continent and in the world over. So their meaningful inclusion is paramount for any sustainable development, for any sustainable growth, for peace, security, and development. So this is a program that provides youth with such safe space and a platform to air out their grievances, identify the challenges they face, and also be a part of crafting the solutions that should address these challenges. Youth assembly concept in Mombasa has had a big impact. It has also, in partnership with between the Oslo Center and Mombasa Youth Assembly, been recognized at the Paris Peace Forum last year, November, where we emerged one of the top 10 programs in terms of youth participation, meaningful engagement, and their overall development. And after that, we embarked on a scalar program where we began in Kwale immediately after the easing of protocols and containment measures around COVID-19. And the reception has been immense. The youth have embraced this as a tool to amplify their voices, channel their grievances, and offer alternative leadership and solutions to the challenges that they face. It is also a platform that is also bringing leaders closer to the people, and for this matter in case, the youth, to be able to be a part of these discussions that come up with the policy, public policies that affect their day-to-day lives. And this is in recognition that the policies that are being crafted today will affect the youth the longest. And it is important they are part of these discussions. It's important that their views are included. It is important for sustainable development and growth for any country that youth are part of this. And being here today in Lamu just goes further to demonstrate just how important youth organizations like this one is critical. Looking at the challenges the young people themselves have identified, the target groups that these challenges affect the most, and also some of the strategies they are proposing in terms of addressing this challenges, it is quite a timely program, and it is quite timely that we're here in what is now looking like a post-COVID period, where governments at national and subnational level will be putting in place strategies and mechanisms to recover what has been contracting economies, not just in Lamu, not just in Kenya, not just on the continent, but the world over, due to the crisis that we have all faced. And the youth are embracing this as a tool through which they can be a part of this conversation. They can meaningfully participate and give their views in terms of how they want to see their future look like in terms of the policies that will be put in place. And for the Oslo Center, this is exciting because it is just not only implementing the Constitution of Kenya, but it is also helping and bridging the gap between the governance authorities, the youth and communities at large. And we hope that the eagerness, the zeal, the passion we have seen today will continue to be the guiding light and support the youth towards achieving their objectives and towards bringing about change within their communities, and also impacting accountable service delivery within their communities.